Good evening. Good evening. It is Valerie McDowell, your writer, editor, author, book coach, and consultant. I feel like I've been away for so long. It's only been 2 weeks. But welcome to May. It is May 3rd. It is the first Wednesday of the month. So this is when we come on before you so we can put you back at the top of your writing list. For those that don't know me, I work with writing and time challenge clients, helping them get their stories told, their books published, and their dreams fulfilled. And since about 2019, I've helped well over 40 first-time authors go from idea to publish in as little as 3 months, and at least about 100 people have taken my online course. So I'm just excited that I get to help you tell your stories. And one of the things I want to talk about today is a beloved story that I had the pleasure of going to see this weekend. And that story was based on a childhood book I read by one of my favorite childhood authors, Miss Judy Blume. And many of you also have that same connection with her, that in elementary school, middle school, you were reading her books, of which some were banned even back then. And I'm talking about the 70s and 80s. So, OMG, we're still going through it. But these were critical stories that really helped us young ladies go through that period. You know, many of our parents and grandparents or guardians, whoever raised you, you know, everyone was not open and honest and sharing information that you needed to know about what was going on. And, you know, some of it had to do with they weren't told and you just kind of figure things out. But Judy Blume took on the responsibility of letting all kinds of girls know what was coming, what's happening. This is how I feel. And so I just honor her even today. She's 85 years old, out here still making a difference in the world and just happy to see. And I hope that they do a whole lot more of her books from the early elementary, like Super Fudge and Fudge and Sheila the Great, to, you know, her older books for older young adults. So to get started, it was just like, so you know where I'm going. And those of you who are on my mailing list will also get the opportunity to hear a little bit more about this book. But my topic tonight, I just wanted to say, based on, you know, viewing this movie and everything, is that your story is not their story, okay? And that was one of the lessons I think I got watching the movie that, and this is, you know, information for all of you that, you know, your story is not my story, but that's okay because we all have a story. Now, how many of you have heard me say that when it comes to writing your book? That, you know, even when there's a book that has the same title, even when it seems like the premise is the same, your version of it, the way you tell it, your insight, how you saw it, your perspective, it's all going to be different. So again, I want to share with you today about my favorite, one of my favorite books from childhood, Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret. So that's the movie that's out, Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret. And, you know, like I said, it just helped to recall just all the wave of emotions and just sentiments. And I just had a big smile on my face when I heard it was coming out, when they were making it a movie. And so, like I said, I went to see it this past weekend. And as the movie progressed, it was just amazing to be taken back to that time, even as a adult, and understand that we are still dealing with some of these same issues. And so questions that they were asking, like, will they like me? Do I fit in? Why is it taking so long? What is happening to my body? God, are you there? And it's just funny that these are still the same questions we ask today. Like, we get a new job, we move to a new community, we meet new people, we join a church, we date someone, you know, maybe we're married, not married, whatever, starting new relationships. Will they like me? And so we still ask these questions no matter what age we are. Do I fit in? Another question. Again, you go to a new school, you take courses, you haven't been in school in a long time. You move to a new neighborhood. Do I fit in? You take a class, you haven't moved that part of your body. Do I fit in? Why is it taking so long? You know, one of the things about patience is don't pray for patience because God's going to make you wait. You know, but the thing is throughout life, you know, And, you know, I read something years ago that talked about, you know, we pray to grow up when we're young. It's like, oh, we have a baby. Oh, when will the baby, you know, get teeth? And then when will they start walking? And when will they start running? When will they go to school? When they go to school. Okay, when will they graduate? Okay, they graduate. When will they get married, get a job? All the, and it starts all over again. So we are constantly waiting for something to happen. But I want to just say to you to pause. Enjoy every moment. Take time to make sure you're enjoying every moment of your life because it goes so fast. We cannot get back to time. So maximize the moments. Take time to enjoy each moment. When something great happens, enjoy. Even if something sad happens, cry. You know, get those feelings out now. And that's what I loved about the book, because every emotion that Margaret was having, it was like, God, okay, I need you to do this. Or don't do that. Or I don't want to move. Please let us not move. So you're going to go on a roller coaster of emotions, whether you are 12 or 45 or 72, you know, whatever the age is, you're going to go through a series of emotions because life will bring us new adventures at each turn. You know, things that happen to us at 12, we're experiencing some other things as you get a little older. And so, you know, I'm going to say, what about you? What are some of the questions that you ask? Okay. You know, we saw what she was asking as her, you know, preteen body was going through puberty, you know, doing it in a new state. Because one of the premises of the book is they were moving from Jersey to, from New York rather to Jersey. And I love this book because I had that same experience a little earlier than her, but it was like, why are we moving from New York to New Jersey? You know, it was like, New York was fabulous, you know, and then you move to suburban, like, what is this Jersey place, you know? But so I am a transplant of both. It's like, I spend probably equal amounts of time in both states. And so, but I'm a native New Yorker. Let's just make that clear. Hey, Melanie, how you doing, sweetie? You agree with the statement? Yes, enjoy every moment. And so, you know, as I was watching this movie again, it was just like, what I was thinking about was like, what about you? You know, as a grown-up, I'm not sure it's possible to watch and not see that awkward little girl you were growing up, you know, that you used to be. And now, like, I think parts of that movie hit you harder, especially if you've hit 50 or you're above, you know, because all the things that you were just waiting so eager, like, oh God, please, 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 hurry up. I want this to happen. And then now that all those things have happened and now other things are happening, it's sort of like, you know, those, the secrets of what you were waiting for as a young girl have all you've experienced. But deep inside, there's always that part. And that's what I found myself experience. And even as I looked around, because I'm very observant, you know, I'm venturing into filmmaking. And so I've always been a movie buff. I've always been, you know, aware of audience, their participation, what's happening on the screen, people's reactions. And so even sitting in the theater, and I went actually to a nonprofit theater in my community, and your ATE, I love it. That's right. Make every day count. And so, because I went to this nonprofit theater, you know, just to support local endeavors, and it's been there for a long time, and many of the audience members had gray hair or gray hair covered by other hair or other colors or hats or whatever it was. But it was just wonderful to see because there was definitely a blend of ages in that theater watching this movie, which, you know, I was so excited to see because the movie was pretty full, you know, that so many people came out to see this coming of age story because the little girl in all of us, the boy in all of us, you know, all the stages that we go, they mean so much in the moment, you know, because it's like nothing else matters. It's like if you've got preteens or teenagers in your house, you realize how they really don't think about you. It's like, so when they're little and you are their world, enjoy it because the minute they get older, hey, Eloise, good to see you there. Because when your kids start getting older and their friends are become more important, what they're doing, you know, you're going to be like, I remember when. So this movie has so many moments of memory, recalling, you know, the awkwardness, you know, of the time, the embarrassment, and even just the awakening of so many things in your mind, how you think about things, how you feel, even about yourself. And so I think, you know, as I was saying, just like the character in the movie, she grappled with insecurity, she grappled with fears and uncertainty. And I think similar questions come up when we're writing our own book, you know, that I have many clients who are like, hey, let me know. I hope it's good. You know, I hope I didn't write too much, or let me know if it's any good. So we still have those same feelings when we go through our own work. Like, is my book any good? Will anyone read it? That's a big one that I get a lot. Or how do I tell my story? It's kind of difficult. Like, it's got trauma and some other stuff, and I don't want to make anybody mad. So all those kind of feelings are still there, you know, that take us back to that child, that little girl who's like, do I fit in? Will they like me? You know, will they like my book? Will they like what I said? Will they still be my friend? So I just thought that, wow, what a, you know, a collection of memories and recollections of how, you know, even at advanced ages, you still find those moments where the little girl in you just wants to be seen, you know. And I think about also about I was part of PTA when my son and daughter were in school. And so sometimes, you know, some of the parents who came was like, hey, can you help me, or find how can I help my child? You know, it wasn't about tutoring, but they really wanted to be able to support their child with homework. But for some parents, especially with math or subjects that they may not have been good in themselves, that fear, that insecurity all comes rushing back. It's like, oh, I remember Miss Johnson, and she's like, ah, you know, or you know, and so parents don't want to venture down those roads because they are reminded of their own, you know, insecurities and fears around things that they were not comfortable with. And what this movie actually also talked about was just, how do we navigate unfamiliar places? You know, when we have to do something new, when we have to try something new. I mean, none of you guys were authors until you were. No one wrote a book until they wrote a book. No one wrote a poem. No one wrote a short story. No one worked wherever you worked, in real estate, in, you know, federal government, you know, whatever your profession is. No one did it, you know, until you did. You know, I remember having that conversation with someone. Nobody's the president until they're the president. So all the people that want to be president, it's like, yeah, it's a great aspiration. But until you are, then we understand why the gray hair comes, why the stress every single day. The list is forever, you know, and you think you have a lot to do in your own life. So for all the things that we venture, you know, it's not so much that you cannot do it. It's just unfamiliar. You just haven't learned how to do it. You haven't learned, you know, the tools, the techniques, the strategies. And even as I venture upon some new things coming up in my own life, like, I mean, I just took a filmmaking class and it was just like amazing, but I never did. I mean, I'm a writer through and through, and I have learned bits and pieces, but this was such a thorough class. And shout out to Terrell Chavon. Yes, Lord, this woman is amazing. And, you know, she's like, you know, we're already talking about film festivals and producing and, you know, budgets. And oh my God, like, how did we get in? And it's only been like 5 weeks. So I'm just excited for even taking that lane, you know, as part of my writing craft, you know, that there's so many ways that you can use the gift that you have. And so just 3 points I want to leave you with today. I always got to give you some support, some help, you know, as we navigate not only our writing world, but our personal worlds. And so be nice. One of the things in the movie, and it's always funny that whenever you see coming of age movies, there's always the mean girls. And even as adults, there are going to be those mean people, and they're everywhere. They're just taller and they have titles now. So just know they're going to be there. And just like in the movie, when you realize that they really don't have it all together and they really look at you like, and you have things they want. And so just be nice. Okay. Because they're going to fall off once you become more secure in who you are. You know, they're not even, they're going to be like, you just buzz them away. Number two, be helpful. One of my gifts is to help, you know, and actually Martin Luther King said, we all can do that. We can all help. You know, we live in a world where people feel that they are competing with each other. I mean, you can go on any social media, anything where it's like, look at me, I have this, I have that. And it's like, you know, it's really not about that. Because when you understand how unique and how valuable you are, then, and that there's no one like you, then it's easy to support others. You know, supporting can become your superpower because you're not taking away anything from who you are when you help. In fact, you're going to get more because you're being affirmed that what you have and what you are giving to others is something that they need, you know, and they will tell you like, oh my God, that was so good. Thank you. Because, and the more you pour, the more will be poured into you to pour out. But you do have to be careful. You know, you can't go empty all the time. But the thing is, it's like helping and supporting others because you're not competing. You're only competing with yourself. What's the last thing you did? Okay, do you need to do something else? Like, I can list things I do. And do I want to do that better? Do I want to do more of that? Or you don't like that. Don't do that anymore. That's a conversation with me. I don't have to talk to anyone else about what I like because I know it's like, you know, with certain things, it's like changing diet and stuff. It's like, well, you really should eat avocado every week. You know, I like guacamole, but just straight avocado doesn't really appeal to me. Like, so I'm not slicing it up for it to just be looking at me like, okay, eat it. I don't want it. No, I'm not going to chop it up and stuff. If it's not in guac, it's probably not going to work for me. There are a million other things I can eat, though, that will bring me those same nutrients and vitamins and minerals and all the wonderful things that it brings. So you need to know what works for you. And then so number one, be nice. Number two, be helpful. And number three, be yourself. And isn't this wonderful? You know, we went to a childhood story. And so we have some things that we learned in childhood about being nice, being helpful, and being yourself. When the characters try to like someone or do things they didn't like or be like someone, you know, they saw how it didn't work for them. You know, in fact, that it backfired. And so they learn to drop that facade because being yourself is the easiest way to be free. And when you're free, ideas flow, creativity springs forth, and your stories will be that much richer. So the author, and I'll just end with this, Judy Blume, she lived in Elizabeth, New Jersey, which wasn't too far from where I lived in Morristown, New Jersey. So I was like, what? So, you know, when you're a kid, you're like, oh my God. It's like learning your teacher's first name back in the day. I mean, now kids know they can go online and see. But, you know, back in the day, it was like, oh my God. Because they were always Mr. or Miss somebody, you know. But when you learn their first name, like my second grade teacher's middle or first name, her name was Lynn Brown. And so my middle name is Lynn. I was like, oh my God, her name is like my middle. Oh my, you know, and it's just like the things that, you know, bring special memories, make you feel a connection to someone, like, you know, and someone may discount it, but to you, it means the world. And so I just wanted to share my book with you. One of my favorite books from childhood, Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret, which is now movie. And Forever is on Netflix. So they have a documentary about the book Forever, which was another one of those books they were banning, like taking from you if you had it in school. So it's just like, this is nothing new. Okay. It's like, you know, and part of it is because some parents and some people didn't feel that you were old enough for certain reading materials. But the thing is, kids learn at different levels. You know, all kids don't learn at the same levels. And though maybe some of the material might have been more advanced, you know, it's still about, you know, what's your capacity? You know, I was one of those kids that, you know, if there was a contest, read 50 books or read 100 books, I'm winning that prize. You know, I remember I got roller skates in the third grade for reading 50 books over the summer. We doing that, you know? And so it's like, you know, your capacity is different from mine, which is why I titled this, Your Story is Different, you know, from someone else's story, because we don't have the same story, but we can come together and share our stories and make it that much richer for us to be connected. So I am Valerie McDowell, your writer, editor, author, book coach, and consultant, and I love stories. So if you got one and you want to get yours published, hit me up. Let's get it done. We got 4-5 in process right now. And Melanie, we're going to be taking a look at yours real soon. All right. Have a great evening. I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.